Very good morning, students. I hope that you all are well at your homes. So, students, let's start our English class. So today we had completed question and answers and word meanings of chapter 7, the question of mangoes. And today we'll start completing the exercises of chapter 7. So let me share your ebook in front of you on your screen. I hope that ebook is visible. Is that visible to you all? So let's start completing. We have completed question answer. First question also I sent you yesterday on your WhatsApp group. Now let's start doing exercise of this chapter. So here, open page number 88 page number of your book. Sarthak, on your camera. Yes. Now, here in this exercise, listen to the amazing fact about ants. Ants and make and mark the sentences as true or false. So here for this exercise, you have to move to page number 164 of your book. Here you will find out in chapter 7, there is something written about ants. Understand? Something is written about ants. So you have to read that thing, that paragraph you have to read, and you have to mark here according to that paragraph, true or false. That whether these sentences are true or false. Or which sentence is true or which is false. Understand? I hope you all can do this exercise by yourself easily. Can you do this exercise?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Now move to the next exercise, grammar. Gerunds. Read the following sentences. Wind was blowing over the mountains. The little girl started fanning herself. In these sentences, the verb plus ing form is used. The verb plus ing form is used to form continuous tense. Remember, the verb plus ing form is also used to act as an adjective, noun or verb. That is to form gerunds or participles. Pratyanshu, on your camera. You're not visible. Now, the verb plus ing form may also be used as noun. This noun can be used as a subject or object of the verb. As a subject or a object or a subject or object of the verb. Verb plus ing. Read these sentences. Eating at fixed hour is a good habit. He hasn't stopped eating late at night. In this sentence 1, eating is a subject of verb is. In sentence 2, eating is subject of verb stop. Here verb is there and there is a subject is eating. Verb plus ing. When ing form of a verb is used as noun, it is known as gerunds. Pratyanshu, stop sending messages. Please pick the gerunds from the sentence. Here you just have to pick up the gerunds from the sentence. This exercise is very easy. I hope you all can do. Can you do this exercise? We just have to find out gerunds. Yeah, the first word is walking is good for health. Which is gerund here?
No, walking.
Who is giving the answer?
Ma'am.
Partha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Walking is good for health. What is the meaning of this sentence, Sartha? Please tell the class.
Ma'am, in Hindi?
Yes.
Ma'am, chalna sehat ke liye acha hota hai.
Yes, very good. So here walking is the gerund. I hate sleeping in the afternoon. Yes, Srishti?
Ma'am, sleeping.
Yes. Veena is fond of listening to the music.
Ma'am?
Listening.
Yes. Ma'am. My grandma is very good at telling stories. Yes?
Ma'am, telling.
Ma'am, yes. Telling.
Telling.
Ma'am, we have to do this word quiz also.
You can do this word quiz by yourself?
Yes, ma'am. First one will be strong.
The dash and his iron determination to get 50 anas. Here the word iron stands for?
Strong.
New, weak, old. What is the answer?
I'm strong.
I'm strong.
Yes, answer is strong. Very good. Move to the next exercise. Participles and stable verbs. Read the following sentences. The verb plus ing form can be used like an adjective to tell us something more about the noun. When used as an adjective, it is used on its own without the helping verb. The winning team will be awarded a special prize. Such adjective form verbs with the help of ing are usually called present participles. The form of participles like that of a gerund, verb plus ing. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the verbs given in the bracket. The words can be gerund or participles. So tell me the answer. I must thank for dash me decorate the Christmas tree.
Ma'am, helping.
Helping.
I'm helping.
Exactly. In these sentences, you just have to add ing with the words given. Helping me decorate. Helping me decorate the Christmas tree. She started. Answer is?
Cleaning. Ma'am, cleaning.
Yes, she started cleaning. Cleaning the room before her mother came. Dash to loud music gives me a headache.
But ma'am, listening.
Listening to a loud music is gives me headache. My aunt likes baking.
Baking.
Cakes for her family. I think you will like swimming.
Swimming. Jogging. Ma'am, jogging.
Swimming. Jogging. What is the spelling of jogging?
Ma'am, jogging.
Spelling.
Ma'am, J-O-G. Ma'am,
J-O-G-G-N-I-N-G.
J-A-O-G.
No, ma'am.
G-I-N-G. J-O-G-G-I-N-G. Double G-I-N-G.
Double G.
The dash doll was the best doll. The laughing doll. Laughing doll was the best doll. Go to the next exercise. Complete the passage using word from the box. Playing, running, these words are here. When Pied Piper came to Hamelin, he saw rats dash around. He saw rats running around. Okay, I'll write the numbers only. Running around. They ran all over the palace. eating cheese and making nests. Number three, making nests in the people's hat. Hindpiper told the mayor of Hamelin that he could rid the town of rats, but they would have to pay a price. The mayor agreed. Hindpiper began dash a queer melody.
Jumping.
Playing. Answer is playing here. Playing a queer melody. The rats started following him. Hindpiper led all the rats straight to the river. Dash and dash, hopping and jumping. Hopping and jumping. These are the answers. Okay, blank. Move to the next exercise. Learn new word. Read each of the following and circle the correct synonym. We have to circle the correct synonym here. Synonym means the similar meaning, same word. Compensate. What is the similar word of compensate? What is the synonym? Yes, Srishti?
Ma'am, pay.
Pay, yes. Compensate means to pay. Permit. Shallow, allow, endless, present. Yes, Srishti?
Ma'am, shallow.
Permit means allow, not shallow. Permit means allow karna, permission dena. Sequence, order, final, written, sense.
Ma'am, sense.
Ma'am, order.
Yes, it's not sense part, it's order. This sequence means, har cheez jo hogi hai, usko sequence mein rakhni chahiye. Like number one is number two, number three, number four. This is called order, proper order mein rakhni chahiye. So the similar word of sequence is order. Another meaning is also something of order, but we don't have to think about that. Sequence, synonym of sequence is order. From. What is the synonym of prompt?
Quick.
Yes, it's quick. To do something prompt, quickly. Move to the next exercise. Now, fill in the blanks using the words given in exercise A and complete the sentences. So, from here we have to find the correct word and put here. The teacher will allot a dash to each one of us.
Ma'am,
task. Task means work. The owner wanted me to dash for the broken glass. Yes.
Ma'am,
compensate means pay. My father will not dash me to go to the movie tonight as I have not studied for exam. My father will not
permit.
Exactly, it's permit. Permission. Dena. I never expected such dash answer.
Such sequence?
Prompt answer. Prompt means quick, fast. I have not expected. I never expected. Such prompt answer. Please arrange the answer in sequence. Sequence. Move to the next exercise. Divyansh, do you have any doubt? Divyansh Mishra, do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Turn off your mic, please. Whenever you have doubt, just then that case, just on your mic. Otherwise, different sounds are coming from your side, are disturbing the class. Please take care of this. And Ara, do not touch the screen, please. Exercise number B. Complete the sentences given below by using adjectives. Here we have to complete the sentences using adjectives. The dash butterfly have many dash colors. The flying butterfly. Flying butterflies have many beautiful colors. Susie planted dash flower in the flower pot. Susie planted sweet flowers. There were ducks that swam in the muddy pond. It was a dash day. Srishti, press off your mic. It was a dull day. Children jumped into the dash water of cool water to cool off. Children jumped in the cool water to cool off. The dash children went home to rest. The tired, T-I-R-E-D, tired children went home to rest. Move to the next exercise, which is punctuate. This is very simple exercise which you can do. I hope you all have written. Move to the next exercise. Punctuate. Use full stop and commas wherever necessary. I hope you all can do this. Can you do this? You just have to use full stops and commas.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it's very simple
exercise. I will complete this exercise.
Very good. So complete this exercise and write down all the exercise on your notebook as well. Don't forget this. Write the plural form of these words. Can you write the plural form also?
Yes, ma'am.
A child is children.
Yes, ma'am.
Plural form of leaf is?
Ma'am, leaves. Ma'am, leaves.
Yes.
Baby. Ma'am, leaves.
Baby is?
Ma'am, baby command.
Ma'am, babies. Ma'am, babies.
The plural form is babies.
Babies.
Babies. Let me write that. Otherwise, I know that you will not do the mistake. Children. The plural form of child is children. The plural form of leaf is leaves. The plural form of baby is babies. The plural form of monkey is monkeys. Plural form of shower is
shower.
Showers. The plural form of box is boxes. Plural form of beer. Plural form of beer is beer. Understand, it's not beers. Plural form of horse is horses. Is that clear? So this exercise is also completed. And with this exercise, our term one portion of English is also completed. We have completed the term one portion. We still have 10 minutes. So, if you have any doubt, you can ask me here. And then we'll move to our grammar portion from tomorrow onwards. Okay, I hope you all have this book. I don't today this book.
But tomorrow is Sunday.
Oh, yes. I mean from next class. Our next class will be on Thursday. Yes, if you have any doubt,
ma'am, what you do in that second one.
Sorry? Yes, Chavi?
Ma'am, you what do in this one? I don't listen.
Sorry? Listen? In listen exercise you are talking about?
No, ma'am. In 90 page B exercise I not done because I write this one.
In 90 page number, which exercise? This? Fill in the blanks.
Yes, ma'am.
This fill in the blanks. I just told the answer to everyone. I just told the answer to everyone, the answer which will come here. The teacher will not allow or will allot a task. First one is task. Second is permit. No, second is compensate. Yes. Second is compensate. Third is permit. Fourth is prompt. And fifth is sequence. Yes. Well, don't worry about this. You'll get the video of this class after some time on your WhatsApp. Understand? Don't worry. You will get the video of this class. Then you will get find out the answer of all the exercise. Do not touch the screen, please, students. In our grammar, if you have doubt, even you can ask me. Yeah. Well, our English glitter term one portion is completed. That was up to chapter 7, the question of mangoes, which we have completed. Now, we can move to our...
Ma'am.
And also, yes, Srishti. Yes, students. So, students, let's start our grammar portion of our English grammar book. I hope you all have this book open. Page number, open chapter 12, page number 54. Let me share the ebook in front of you all. I hope you all can see the screen, chapter 12, pronouns.
So here, ma'am, I don't have book.
You don't have book? Who don't have book?
Ma'am, Chavi wants English grammar book to PDF. That's why she copies it and then.
That's okay, Chavi. You can complete. You can take out the print of those PDF. This will be helpful for you. So let's start chapter 12. Pronoun. Pronoun is a word that is used in place of noun. We all know that. What is pronoun? Pronoun is a word that we use in place of noun. Read the following sentences. Rita is a good student. Rita completes her homework every day. Rita has many friends. Rita also dances well. Here we are using Rita all over the sentence. So instead of Rita, we can use she. As you can see here, Rita is a good student. She completes her homework every day. She has many friends. She also dances well. We are using she in place of Rita. Now, types of noun. Personal noun, personal pronoun, types of pronoun. Personal pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphatic pronoun, and possessive pronoun. Personal pronoun. Pronouns which are used in place of the names of person, place, animal, person, animal, and things are called person, personal pronoun. Bathe, do not touch the screen, please. Examples. The book is lying on the table. Pick it up. Here, it is used in place of noun. We can see it is a personal pronoun. There are three forms of personal pronoun. I hope you all have grammar book, grammar notebook. You all have to write the definition of pronoun and personal pronoun and all the types of pronoun and their definition on your grammar, English grammar notebook. What is personal pronoun? Personal pronoun which are used in place of name or person, animal or thing. Name of person, place, animal, thing. Person, animal, and thing. Understand? किसी भी चीज़ के, किसी भी person के, किसी भी animal के name के place पे, if we are using some another word, then that word is called personal pronoun. These types of words are personal pronoun. There are three forms of personal pronoun: first person, second person, and third person. Read the following conversation between Aman and Varun. I am going to the park to play. When will you come? No, let us wait for Raj. When will he come? He will come at 6 o'clock. So here first person is this, means I. Second person is you, which is Varun. And third person is Raj, which they both were talking about. Understand? They both were talking about Raj, who is third person. Ved, on your camera, please. Sahil, do not touch the screen. I is the person speaking. You is the person spoken to. He is the person spoken about. I, we are pronoun of first person. You is a pronoun of second person. He is, she, it, they are pronoun of third person. Like now, pronoun can be singular and plural also. He will go, singular. They will go, plural pronoun. Pronouns have gender. He, she, it, I, you. So he is masculine, she is feminine, it is neutral gender, I and you are common gender. Let us look, take a look at a various form of the personal pronoun. Here you can see the various form of the personal. First person is I, me for singular. Gender is common and plural is, plural of I, me is we and us. Second person is you, singular for singular. Gender is common, sabke liye use hota hai. Plural is you. Plural be you here. Third person, he, she, him, her, it. These are singular. Gender are male, female, and neuter. And plural is they or them. Now move to the exercise here. You can see over exercise. Yes, Chavi, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, in person pronoun, there are subject and object.
You can see here, subject and object both are here. Names of animal, person or thing. Kisi bhi cheez ke naam ko, kisi bhi animal ke naam ko, aur kisi bhi person ke naam ko. Agar hum unke naam ke place mein koi bhi word hum use kar rahe hain, those words are called personal pronoun. Which type of pronoun those words are? Those words are type of personal pronoun. And you can see here in the definition which is given, pronoun is a word which we use in place of noun. We all know that. Understand? And subject and object to her sentence mein hota hai. We just have to find out the correct subject. Here the book is lying on the table. Which is subject? Subject is the book. And the predicate is lying in the table. This is the predicate. Understand? I hope you understood that. Huh. Now move to the exercise of this chapter. A. Exercise A. Underline the personal pronoun in the following sentence and write the person for each. So here we have to underline the personal pronoun. And we have to write the person. That first person, second person or third person. Which person is this? First question is, they are good in studies like him. Tell me which is the personal pronoun in this sentence and which person is this? Tell me the answer. Which is personal pronoun in this sentence? They are good in like studies like him. Yes, tell me, Srishti.
Ma'am, they are... They are persons and him are pronoun.
They and
him is, yes, ma'am. They is plural.
Yes. They sorry.
Plural.
We are asking, we have to find out the personal pronoun. The personal pronoun and person, which person is this? Understand? We have to find out the personal pronoun, kaun sa hai isme se, sentence mein, and kaun sa person hai. So let me tell you the answer. is personal pronoun and him is personal pronoun. They both are personal pronoun. And the person which they belong to is third person. Understand? They are of third person. First person, second person, they are third person. Hey. I is first person. I is first person. You is second person. And third person is the person which we are talking about. हम दोनों जिसके बारे में बात कर रहे हैं किसी third person के बारे में. That third person is they, him. As we found here, ना यहाँ पे भी हमने देखा था इस कॉलम में. You can see here. थर्ड पर्सन में कौन कौन से वर्ड्स आते हैं. ही, हिम, शी, हर, इट, दे, देम. ये सभी वर्ड्स आते हैं फर्स्ट पर्सन में. अंडरस्टैंड? ये जो सभी वर्ड्स हैं, ये सॉरी ये सभी वर्ड्स थर्ड पर्सन में आते हैं. ये सभी वर्ड्स किस में आते हैं? थर्ड पर्सन में. एंड ये सभी वर्ड्स किस में आते हैं? दीज वर्ड्स कम इन सेकेंड पर्सन. दीज वर्ड्स कम इन थर्ड पर्सन. These all words come in third person. I hope you understood that. समझ में आया सबको? Have you all understood? You just have to find out. अब इसमें they and him. They and him are personal pronouns. We know that, and they belong to third person. It's very simple exercise. Next is Sonia has gone to the market with her. So here her. Her is personal pronoun. And which person it belongs to? Her.
Third.
Yes. Her is of third person. I live with them in that village. Tell me.
Ma'am, I.
Yes, I. And one more personal pronoun is there. Them.
Ma'am, I is.
I.
Ma'am, I.
Them. Them is third person and I is first person. Okay? You should not worry about him. Here, you is personal pronoun and him is personal pronoun. Understand? So, you is second person, we all know that, and him is third person. The dog is hurt, so it is limping. So here, it is third person. It is personal pronoun and the person it belongs to is third person. Now here we have to next exercise. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate pronoun. Shubh and Manoj are friends. Dash live in Chandigarh. Answer is, they live in Chandigarh. Neeta is a good student. Dash stands first in class. Answer is, she stands first in class. We know Mr. Mathur. Dash is our neighbor. Here he is our neighbor. Vineet is not alone. Jay and Vinay are with him. Get the file. The boss wants it now.
No, it's not.
Sorry? So this is the exercise, students. I hope that you all have completed. And we'll complete rest of the topic in our next class. Demonstrative pronoun. From demonstrative pronoun we have to complete. If you have any doubt, you can ask me, students.